Now we will have a look at the loco's pre-shift check. We see that the loco key is turned and now the electronic key will be switched on, and before the loco can start moving, the pre-shift check must be done. We'll check the pre-shift key. You can hear the siren. Yes. Once we have verified that all the lights are working, the operator must open the loco door and close the loco door, press the emergency stop, depress it, acknowledge that he heard the siren. There you can really check the key, and now the static brake test is taking place. Brakes is tested in both directions, and from here the pre-shift check can go to the caboose side. Now we are going to do the pre-shift check in the caboose side. So we're moving to the caboose, and in the caboose the guard is that is going to do the pre-shift check. Now we will press the emergency stop and test that the emergency stop is working. The internal buzzer is working, and we will check that the control handle is working in both directions. Once it's done, we have it all clear. Now we're going to demonstrate the front driven capability of the diesel loco. We can see the operator approaching us, operating the loco from the locomotive, and he's facing the direction of travel. The handset has also been changed in such a way that it also faces the direction of travel. And here we can see the caboose of the locomotive. Now we can see the operator getting out of the locomotive. He takes his handheld module, closes the locomotive so the door switch and the system can see it's closed, and he gets into the caboose with his handset. We will first need to cradle the handset and close the caboose door. Once the caboose door is closed, you can start operating from the caboose side. There we can see the locomotive is being operated from the caboose. Now we will demonstrate the loco's operation with the handset. We will see that the operator is signaling from the handset. He signals the direction of travel. The loco accepts the signal, and now we can start moving the loco with the tilt of the handset. First he's moving it forward, now backwards. And we can see that you can move the loco very precisely with the handset, and there is perfect control. Move it a bit backwards, and if you hit the button, the loco stops immediately. Now we will move the loco backwards. Now we can see that the loco can move very precisely. With very, very small movements on the handset, the loco will react, taking it both in the forward and in the backwards direction. And the moment you tilt the handset, the loco will stop. we will uncouple using the handset. First we will remove the pin, and the operator is moving the loco with the handset. Now once coupling, we will use the handset to couple the loco again. The operator is facing the rolling stock. We will first signal the loco to start moving with his eyes on the stock, on the rolling stock. We will keep it there. We can move the loco very precisely, forwards and backwards, and then coupled. Takes the pin, drops the pin, and the loco is coupled.